Hey, what's up guys? So finally the video you guys all been waiting for, and here we are. So I'm gonna go through this because obviously it's gonna be very SaaS based, so I'm gonna try to cover as much depth as I possibly can. Obviously I did put the video up on my Facebook Keyforge group about asking what people think, like in terms of the sets and what they want me to talk about, and obviously what these decks would be for beginners to end. I mean, to be honest, each deck gets more complicated. Each set gets more complicated. So, I mean, each one brought something different to Keyforge. So, I mean, we'll start with the standard one. What's called Call of the Archons. And then we've got your Age of Ascensions, World Collide, Mass Mutation. So, each one brought something different. Obviously, Age of Intention introduced a new kind of concept, Alpha and Omega cards. Worlds Collide got the anomalies and a few different things in that one. These two probably very similar to each other, obviously, apart from the Alpha Omega thing. And then obviously this one's introduced the enhancements. So each deck brings a bit more complication, or obviously something new to learn. So I would just go in order. So I think Keyforge, Fantasy Flight, you know, designers know what they're doing. Because obviously they're going through and making each set a little bit different. So they're evolving each time, and each one's bringing something different to the game. So it's definitely very interesting. I'm going to be opening these four decks here and obviously assessing the SAS, comparing to the overall deck list. And obviously enhancements has certainly made the SAS thing a bit more complicated. And we'll get into that a bit later down the line. But let's just start. Gonna go in an order that you guys may not expect, or shall I go in order just for your guys' sake? I think I'm gonna go in my order that I've decided, and reason for that would come out afterwards. So we're gonna go AOA first. So this deck, I know who has the most powerful Age of Ascension deck. I've seen it in action at the Grand Championships. I know the guy personally as well, and very nice dude. Nobody nicer could have that deck if it wasn't possible. And it is an insane, insane deck. Now, Age of Ascension has some really cool cards in there. And how they get used is very different. So let's just start here. Eye of Judgment, action, purge a creature from your discard pile. Logos Ambassador. So this was a new thing as well. And everybody was going crazy about when the set was about to come out. Fight, reap, you may play or use a Logos card this turn. Grey Rider, play fight, reap, you may ready and fight with a neighboring creature. Two of those. Smite, ready and fight with a friendly creature, deal 2 to the attack creature's neighbors. I'm going to try to upload the gear and all in one go, see if YouTube lets me. Shield of Justice, play for the remainder of the turn, each friendly creature cannot be dealt damage. Two of those. Maruk the Marked, after Maruk the Marked prevents damage with this armor, capture 1 amber for each damage just prevented. Healing Blast, play fully heal a creature. If you've healed 4 or more damage this way, gain 2. So, I mean, 3 you could essentially straight off that card. Very cool. Action, choose a creature for the remainder of the turn. The chosen creature cannot be dealt damage. Challenge the Safeguard, deploy its Sword. And we've got a Maverick deck. Cool. Blinding Light. Choose a house, stun each creature off that house. So, his second thing you want going straight in there. Knowledge is Power. This set has stayed pretty consistent through the whole 4 sets, and obviously it's made each deck that it's in pretty powerful. Choose 1 archive card, or for each archive card you have, gain 1 amber. Remote access, use an opponent's artifact as if it were yours. Wild Wormhole, play the top card of your deck. 2 of those, definitely missed that. At the end of your turn, if Titan Librarian is not on flank, archive a card. Standardized testing, play. Destroy each creature with the lowest power and each creature with the highest power. Professor Stuttering Reap, draw a card for each friendly Logos creature. Poke, deal 1 damage to an anomaly creature. If this damage destroys a creature, draw a card. Lab Work, archive a card. Help a bot. You may play 1 non-Logos card this turn. Very cool. Relentless Assault, one of the best problem cards. Ready and fire with up to 3 different friendly creatures, 1 at a time. Or go Pogo. After a Pogo attacks and destroys a creature, you may deal 2 to a creature. Gargantuan Scrapper. So there's the alpha. So that's something new that was in this set. If you have 3 or more amber, deal 2 to an enemy, 3 to an enemy creature. Blood of Titan. This creature gets plus 5 power. Tremor, stun a creature and each of its neighbors. Grok, fight your opponent loses 1. And Gauntlet Command, ready and fight with a friendly creature. Gengar Chieftain, play. You may ready and fight with a neighboring creature. And First Blood Alpha again. Play, deal 2 damage to each friendly Brobna creature. You may divide this damage among any number of creatures. And then Kalfine before fight. 2 to each neighbor of the creature Kalfine fights. Bramo, deal 2 to enemy, to each enemy flying creature. And then finally, Bingle Bang. Bang, so before fight, deal 5 to each neighbor of the creature enemy fights. So, nothing insane in here. So, this set... obviously, Bromna was still in this. Obviously, the new set is gone. And I think a lot of people are pleased about that. Bromna is very powerful in the right combination of cards and combos that you can pull off with it. So, Sanctum's made a comeback. So, that's really weird that these two or three in there. So, let's go on to the next one. And I will do the reveal of the sass and everything at the end. Alright, guys. Welcome back. So, we're going to go with Mass Mutation this time. So yeah, I mean, this is obviously the most recent set. So gigantic creatures, enhancements, and the sins are definitely the three prominent things that's been introduced in this set. I mean, a lot of people are chasing the 7 sins decks. So apparently there's 34 already that have it. So they... oh, this Sanctum and anyone. So Ashrid, let's see. I don't want to waste too much time quickly on wrappers. Come on. Alright, let's get into it. So, no gigantic in this one, but there is likely sins. So, Forging Alliance, one of the older ones. Forge 7. A key at plus 7, current cost reduced by 1 for each house represented among cards in play. Universal Translator Fire Reap, use a friendly non-Star Alliance creature. Lay of the Land, look at the top 3 cards of your deck and put them back in any draw. Any order, draw a card. Teleporter Chief Tink. Action swap, Teleporter Chief Tink with another friendly creature in battle line. You may use that other creature this turn. 2 of those. Subject, can you play Fire Reap? You may play a non-Star Alliance creature this turn. Sensor Chief Garcia, play Fire Reap, keys cost plus 2 during your opponent's next turn. Now during collision, play remove a ward from a creature, deal 3 to it. This damage cannot be prevented by armor. Deal with that. Commander Chan, Fire Reap, use another friendly creature. Blast Shield gets plus 2 armor. After this creature uses its controller, may attach Blast Shielding to one of its creature's neighbors. Access denied, this creature cannot reap. Mighty Lance, deal 3 to a creature and 3 to a neighbor of that creature. Bring Low. Play, capture all but 5 of your opponent's amber. Distributed among any number of friendly creatures. Dover to Heaven, but an interesting one. Amber Heart, Exalt Ward, and that's one of the enhancements. And fully heal a friendly creature. Grey Rider, play Fire Reap. You may ready and fight with a neighboring creature. Seeker of Truth. Fight, you may fight with a friendly creature, friendly non-sanctum creature. Gizelhar Zealot enters play ready and enraged. Fangs of Gizelhar, play, purge the most powerful creature. Burn it, that's another one. Commandeer, play for the remainder of the turn after you play another card. A friendly creature captures one. Burning Glaive, place stun an enemy creature or stun each enemy mutant creature. Bulwark. Very cool looking mutant if I say so. Assault 2. Each Bulwark name is gain Assault 2. Ardent Hero. Ardent Hero cannot be dealt damage, but creatures are creatures with power 5 or higher. Like a Fiend Destroyed, steal 1, it's got Skirmish. Essence Scale. Double thingy there. Destroy a friendly creature if you do. Ready and use a friendly creature that shares a house with the destroyed creature. Cinder Reap, destroy a friendly creature. Implosion, destroy a friendly creature and an enemy creature. So no sins that time. Get rid of this, making a combat, destroy a creature, gain 3 chains, 2 of those. 3 gay with another to get 3. Wow, they're really putting that everywhere. Reap, steal 1, amber, and dominate a bubble. Use friendly creature. And Darkman destroyed. Deal 1 damage to each enemy creature. So we're gonna go and check this sass out. Whoops, rushed out a little bit. So we got Bone Sword at the end. A friendly creature was destroyed this turn. Bone Sword enters play ready. Cool. And you're welcome back, guys. So we're going on to Worlds Collide. So this is the one that did the first big changes. So we got 2 new houses in this one. We got the anomalies. So, and we got introduced to 2 new set of tokens, which was Enrage and Ward. So this is one of the very different decks. So we've got this, Untamed and Star Alliance on this one. So I mean, I've done a lot of opening of this set on my channel, so if you're not seeing the videos, go check them out. Some crazy decks that you get out of this set. One of the ones I've got was 4 Edai, 4 Infernus deck. Infernus would be crazy good in this set. Not in this set, in Mass Mutation. So anyone got 4 Infernus deck in Mass Mutation, keep it. Fight, stun the attacked creature. Map the Mad, Reap, shuffle Map the Mad into your deck. Flexia, gain 2 if you control more creatures than your opponent. Unnatural Selection, choose 3 friendly creatures and 3 enemy creatures, destroy each other creature. And the fittest, give each friendly creature plus 1 power counter. I mean, anomalies are to this set like the gigantic creatures are to the Mass Mutation set. Fight, destroy an artifact. If the artifact had an amber bonus, you gain that much amber. Mustic Marmook, play, deal 4 to a creature. Molfin, after amber is stolen from you, deal 1 to each enemy creature for each amber stolen. 2 of those. Harmonia, after you play a creature, if there are more enemy creatures than friendly creature, gain 1 amber. Play, you may reap with each neighboring creature 1 at a time. Deepwood Druid, play, reap, fully heal a neighboring creature. Ingram's Blaster, fight, reap. You may deal 2 to a creature or attach Ingram Blaster to a Magic Ingram. After you attach Ingram Blaster to a Magic Ingram, fully heal a creature. Special Agent Fingers, action, steal 1. This creature can fight, reap. Use friendly non-Star Alliance creature. Quench Reno Flux, one of very cool looking cards. Choose a friendly creature and an enemy creature, destroy the chosen creature and each creature with the same power as either of the chosen creatures. Navigator Alley, play Fire Reap, look at the top 3 cards of your deck, put them back in any order. Zap, deal 1 to a creature for each house represented among creatures in play. Stealth Mode, your opponent cannot play action cards during their next turn. Science of the King Can, after player chooses an active house which matches no cards in play, steal 1. Red Alert, if there are more enemy creatures than friendly creature, deal damage to each enemy creature equal to the difference. Magic Ingram, play Fire Reap, you may heal 3 damage from a creature and ward it. Explorova, Skirmish, Explorova may be played as an upgraded instead of a creature with the text, this creature gains the Skirmish. Obsidian Forge, nice, very cool card, it's made a comeback in this new set. Action, sacrifice any number of friendly creatures, then you may forge a key at plus 6 current card, reduced by 1 for each creature sacrificed this way. If you do, destroy Obsidian Forge. Library of the Dam, action, archive a card. Bornit's Touch, play, reveal the top 5 cards of a player's deck, purge a card revealed this way, shuffle each other revealed card into that deck. Rock Grub play, your opponent loses 1, reap archive Rock Grub. Malison fight, you may move an enemy creature anywhere in its control by a line, then if it is on flank, it captures one from its own side. Lilithal fight, reap, capture 1. Inspector, destroyed, purge a random card from your opponent's hand. Harbinger of Doom, destroyed, destroy each creature. Festering Touch, choose up to 2 creatures, deal 1 to each chosen creature. If that creature was already damaged, deal 3 instead. 2 of those, and then Exhume, choose a creature in your discard pile. You may play that creature as if it belonged to the active house and was in your hand. And then we finish off on Buzzle. Very cool, interesting, weird looking thing. Play 5, you may purge 1 of Buzzle's neighbors. If you do, ready Buzzle. So no anomalies in that. But yeah, so we're going to carry on. And we're going to go into the last to final. The Call of the Archons. Hello there guys, back again. So we're going on to Call of the Archon. The original, the classic, or will be slowly. They're doing a new set leading soon, so Grey Archon, so we got Shadows, Sanctum, and Probna. That's really weird. Perhaps the most powerful house in this set. And it could be the reason why this deck, well, this set is making waves in a way that I will explain later. And the house has never been the same since. It was okay in the next set, but then it just went downhill from there. I've never got a Fagin deck. I hope I get one here. Urchin, play, steal 1. 2, so 2, and just play ready. 2 of those. 3 of those, wow. As I said it, got a Fagin deck, wow. Wow. Amazing. So something interesting came out of that. Bad Penny. Destroy, return Bad Penny to your hand. Seek a needle action. Deal 1 damage to a creature. If this damage destroys that creature, gain 1. Poison Wave, deal 2 to each creature. Oblate, purge a card with power 3 or lower. Miasma, your opponent skips a Forge a key step on their next turn. Return 2 enemy creatures to the owner's hands. If your opponent has 7 or more, Amber capture all but 5 of it. Staunch Knight gets +2 power armor. Power while it is on flank. Sequoia, reap, capture 1. Sanctum Guardian, fight, reap, swap Sanctum Guardian with another friendly creature in your battle line. Protectrix, you may fully heal a creature. If you do, that creature cannot be dealt damage for the remainder of the turn. Commander Emil, use a friendly non-sanctum creature. Champion Anaphil, we've made a comeback. Taunt, very cool looking card too at that. Hallowed Blaster, action, heal 3 from a creature. Terms of Redress, choose a friendly creature to capture 2. I mean, some people are calling that this might be another house that we may see in the future with more people. Saurians are very similar, I don't know if we need that. Shield of Justice, for the remainder of the turn, each friendly creature cannot be dealt damage. Radiant Truth, stun each enemy creature not on a flank. Troll, one of the coolest Brobnar cards. Reap, Troll deals 3 damage, I mean 8. I mean, there's a gigantic creature that has 8. Or is it? No, it's not a gigantic, it's just a normal one. Crump, after enemy creature is destroyed, fighting Crump, its controller loses 1 amber. Hebe the Huge. So, I mean, Brobnar is very strong in the first set. I mean, look at these big guys. I mean, you would have trouble with these guys if they were on the field. Play deal 2 to each other undamaged creature. Gang of Chieftain, you may ready and fight with a neighboring creature. 2 of those. Can't go wrong with that. Third one would have been even better. Play, your opponent loses 1 amber. That's just full of big guys. Welder, deal plus 2 while attacking an enemy creature on flank. Gauntlet of Command, ready in fight with a friendly creature, so you can do amber generation with this. For remainder of the turn, gain 1 amber each time a friendly creature fights. Punch, 3 damage to a creature. Loot the bodies. For remainder of the turn, gain 1 amber each time an enemy creature is destroyed. And then we've got anger, ready in fight with a friendly creature. So the anomaly regarding this, we got a Fagin deck. So, I mean, I would have loved 3 urchins, but we got 2 there. So, still can't cry about that. Very strong houses. Stringy one in Brobnar. Sanctums. We got pretty strong protect tricks to heal your creatures. So, a pretty solid deck, this one. I think I'm going to say this could be in the 70s, but we'll find out soon enough. 3 Silvertooth, instant 3 Amber, or instantly get to wipe something off the field, depending on what you want to take out. And we'll check that, and we'll go through the results. All right, there we go, sir. So, we are done. So, all 3 car sets. So, received some... The results on this opening didn't reflect, obviously, what's actually going on, really. So, I mean, you saw the decks, so that's the sass on them. Obviously, a lot of people are kind of writing sass off at the moment due to mass mutation having the enhancements, because obviously it can make certain cards very insane, and sass doesn't have the ability to take that into account just yet. So, this is basically showing up what they would be right now, so I'm overquoted, and there was a reason why I said that was going to be like 70, but we'll explain that in a moment. So let's get these aside. So right now, as it stands, all 4 sets, I mean, the new sets has been out for about just over 2 weeks now, so so going through decks of Keyforge, so this is how it kind of plays as the most powerful. So 94 sass, and then goes down. So Kota taking the top 3 spots, then World Collides comes in 4th, 5th. Kota again and World Collides. So they dominate the top 10 decks that are obviously in the going on. And then going on to next. So we don't see mass mutation at number 14. So there is possibility. So World Collide again, and then Quarter taking most of it, and then World Collide. And we don't see Age of Ascension till number 56. So this is the most strongest deck in Age of Ascension. I actually know the person that has this. It's a Sasha deck. It came 2nd in the Grand Championships. It's got double Martian Generosity. It's insane. And that's basically the breakdown of these. So... this kind of gives you an idea of what's going on in the game at the moment. So this is purely on sass. So now one thing we can't obviously judge on is how decks are played, how many games are won. So with the enhancements, it will certainly make a lot of changes to where games are won. So the fact there's these are top 20, but I haven't seen anything, but there's a number 56 that came 2nd in Grand Championship. I can't remember the deck that won, but that was a Kota deck that won the Grand Championship for UK. So that's going to be the one indication of how well these decks do in actual tournaments. So enhancement's certainly going to bring a new kind of thingy. Gigantic creatures, the same anomalies. Saw people saying it's just dead space in your deck. But time will tell. But yeah. That's pretty much has been my breakdown. There's anything if I've missed out that you would have liked to have me to talk about. But that's the way I'm judging it at the moment, the way the sets are set out. Maybe I'll do one way further down the line. If you want to see 4 sets again before the 5th set comes out or something. See if it's made any changes to this top 20. But yeah, keep an eye out, guys. And thank you for watching. Like, subscribe, so hopefully we'll get more stuff coming out for you guys, okay? Bye.